Blue 42. Hut, hut.
Hey everybody, I'm Greg Bedard, the NFL writer at the Boston Globe, here with former Patriots tight end Jermaine Wiggins. We are going inside the Patriots playbook with a look at Sunday's opponents, the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, they've had some troubles, Jermaine, this season, but there's no question that there's a lot of talent on this team on both sides of the ball, especially offensively. And if this guy, Michael Vick, number seven, plays a quarterback, which we expect him to, he just adds another dimension.
Yeah.
But he affects not only the passing game and with his own feet, but he can also affect the running game and present a lot of problems for the defense. Why don't you talk about this? This is a touchdown, LeSean McCoy touchdown, against the Bears in week 9 that really illustrates the kind of double threat that Vic presents.
Yeah, and what this here, what the touchdown is, it's a sprint draw. So Vic comes out here and makes it look like he's running a sprint pass where he could be running a go route to the receiver. There's a lot of different things he could be doing. He could be running a comeback route. So what it does, it gives the illusion of, okay, it could be a sprint pass, but it also gives the illusion of, okay, maybe Vic gets outside the edge and runs. But what they're able to do, as Vic now starts to come out as he's running a sprint, you're going to see McCoy come over like he's going to block. But as Vic comes out, he hands the ball off. And what that does is by them showing the sprint motion, it holds the linebackers, because now the linebackers can't be coming downhill, because they have to be aware for some type of pass play. They have to be aware for Vic, you know, a lot of different things that he can create with his legs. And so it holds this linebacker, and the job on a sprint draw is now the tackle. He makes it look like he's setting back for pass. So you get the end to come upfield. He's going to club him and now climb to that second level and block the linebacker. They're going to work in here, block here. He's going to climb to the second level, cut off backside. So now you have a nice big hole, and as McCoy gets the ball, he's going to have a nice running lane and be able to read his tackle, which who should be pinning him in, and now be able to hit it out the outside. And this receiver is going to probably run him off, block downfield. But what happened with the Philadelphia game, Peters does a good job, but he gets off there late, and this is the athletic ability that McCoy has. He actually makes the linebackers free in the hole, but McCoy makes him miss. And that just goes to show you what type of athlete it is. He makes him miss. Peters is able to now climb and get a safety downfield, but his athletic ability was the reason why this play was successful, and also the fact that Michael Vick is at quarterback. It just creates a lot of matchup problems for the Patriots. They have to think about and be able to decipher a lot of things pre-snap and during the snap of the football.
It's amazing the athletic ability of the Eagles, because, you know, like you said, like McCoy, normally you want the running back to make the secondary defender miss, but he's making a linebacker miss. And I think the other thing that you see that the Eagles, they like to go to these type of plays early. What they'll also run, not only is Vic a threat out here to throw or run, but he'll boot it back. Yeah. And you already have, you have the tight end going out, the tight end, you know, they just present a lot of problems. What do you think about the matchup with the Patriots linebackers against, if Vic's out there, I mean, what kind of challenge is that?
Well, if Vic's out there, what you have to do as a linebacker, you have to be really disciplined, and you have to read before you react. You have to now stay home and play good angles, because you just don't want to be shooting downhill, because Vic has the athletic ability. Once you get downhill and he makes you miss, he has the speed to run by pretty much everybody on the football field. So now you as a linebacker, you have to now be really disciplined and say, okay, I'm going to read and I'm going to see where Vic goes. I'm going to see if he's on a bootleg. I don't want to be chasing and now Vic is out the back door. I got to stay home. I got to play my reads. I got to look, see what's going on. There's going to be a lot of reading done when you're, you know, especially for not just linebackers, but secondary guys. You want to be able to make sure you know where number seven is on the field at all times. And not only is it a sprint, is it a draw? Is it a pass? So it's a lot of read and reacting and being able to decipher those things pre-snap and during the snap is key.
Yeah. Well, this is going to be quite a challenge. A lot of people think that the Patriots defense has improved, which they have. They're executing much better. But, you know, we'll get the proof on Sunday. This is a tough challenge. We can't wait to see it. Thanks for dropping by. We'll see you next week.